welcome. Welcome. Welcome to the Unitarian Universalist Fellowship of Northern Nevada.
If you can hear my voice, clap once. If you can hear my voice, clap twice. Thank you. Listen to Chris, please.
Welcome to the Unitarian Universalist Fellowship of Northern Nevada. My name is Chris Pekars, and my pronouns are he, his, him. I wish to respectfully acknowledge the Washoe, Shoshone, and Paiute people who have stewarded this land on which we're gathered today throughout the generations. We are here today in the spirit of community and generosity. If this is your first time visiting us, we don't usually offer brunch. But we hope you will embrace our welcoming table and break bread with the folks sitting next to you. Much like the bounty of our shared meal today, Unitarian Universalism aspires to nurture you, to sustain you, and encourage you to live your fullest life, to be your true, authentic self, to help you flourish and grow. We don't adhere to any specific dogma, but rather covenant to live together with joy, love, and acknowledgement of our shared human experience without regard to race, gender identity, age, sexual orientation, economic standing, or political affiliation. If you'd like more information on Unitarian Universalism or about our fellowship, please see me, one of our greeters, or stop by the welcome table outside in our gathering room. Any of us will be happy to answer your questions about Unitarian Universalism and how you can become a part of our wonderful family. If you're online or watching this service later in our video archive, please contact our office or visit our website, uufnn.org, for more information. If you're joining us on Zoom today, I'd like to extend an additional warm welcome to you. Please use the chat box to say hi, talk about the service, and when the time comes, engage with our conversation topics. I'm hoping you will enjoy breaking virtual bread with us in our communal gathering celebrating fall's harvest and the upcoming Thanksgiving holiday. And now, a couple of announcements. Check out our weekly e-news, where you'll find all the details of what's happening in and around UUFNN each week. To subscribe to the e-news and to receive other updates, fill out a contact card from your seat back, even though it's hard to see your seat backs right now, or at our front desk or electronically on our website. UUFNN's offices will be closed on Thursday and Friday this week in observation of the Thanksgiving holiday. But tonight is our fun service. This is UUFNN's monthly family-centered dinner service, and dinner is provided, so parents, you have the night off from cooking. There will be activities, songs, and a great opportunity to connect with other families and members here at UUFNN. This is an intergenerational space open to all, and it is in the Star King Room in the adjacent education building. Dinner is served between 5 and 5:45 p.m., and the service and activities begin around 5:45 and will end at 7. Talk to Nathan for more information. Please come and join us. And now Lily has an announcement. There's Lily. Yeah.
Sorry about that. Hi, I'm just going to take this opportunity, I figured we'd have a big crowd today, and we do, to explain a little about Share the Plate, because I have the feeling a lot of people don't quite understand it. So I want to make it clear that you have a choice with Share the Plate. You can write all for the nonprofit on your envelope, if people that regularly donate to the church might feel that's their donation for the church's operation. And so if you put all for share the plate, then whoever we're supporting gets the entire amount. The other option, of course, if you do nothing, it gets split. So I just want to make that clear, because a lot of people some people seem to feel that the operating budget allocates some money to the share the plate recipients, but that isn't the case. And so we just want to make sure everybody's informed, and soon the envelopes will actually say all share the plate, 50-50, or for those of you that make your donations to the fellowship on Sunday mornings, all to the operating expenses. Okay, any questions, you can just check in with me. And remember, feel free to nominate any share the plate, any nonprofits that might be eligible for share the plate. It goes for a month. And as you all know, we collect money every Sunday, and they usually get a check between $1,000 and sometimes $2,000, and they're very grateful. So that's it, thanks.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Linda Bowman. My pronouns are she, her, and hers. And I serve as co-president of the board along with Nancy Oakley, and we just wanted to take a minute to give a heartfelt thanks to the Grounds Beautification Committee. They have done a spectacular time. Thank you. Yes, please. Please, please. This group is led by Bob Quillage, and it includes a dedicated team of volunteers who spend countless hours maintaining and enhancing our campuses. Outdoor spaces. So I just would like to ask if any of you are members or any of you are part of the committee are here and want to give us a wave or stand up so that we know you are here, because it takes a village. Thank you so much. And I appreciate all of you. So that's it. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Nathan Bakken. I use they, them pronouns, and I am the director of congregational life here at UUFNN. And before I open us into our space today, I have one more short announcement. I want to direct everyone's attention to the wall to your right, where it says Ribbon of Joy. This is our annual gift drive for the Women and Children's Center of the Sierras. It is completely online. Those pieces of paper are simply the instructions that you can take a photo of, that you can take off the wall if you would like, or if you look at our weekly e-news, the instructions are there as well, and as well as on the back of the program you got as you walked in today. If you have questions about the Ribbon of Joy, I will invite you to reach out to Adrian. Adrian, could you raise your hand? Or Lois Bianchi, who's not here on this Sunday, they will be able to help you answer any questions you have about our Ribbon of Joy. It's a really great way our community shows up for the wider Reno community during the holiday season. Some folks, as you entered, realized, you know, I'm a little hungrier than I anticipated, and we started eating before I dismissed, and that's fine. And so I'm gonna reorganize my introduction a little bit. And so I wanna invite folks who haven't gone up to get a plate yet, I wanna invite you now to please find your way to getting in line, to getting some food. And once we all have our food, we'll open into the service together. Thank you.
You too, Chris, you're welcome in.
Thank you.
Not to interrupt folks' conversations, but there will be a lot more time for conversing. If you can hear my voice, clap once. If you can hear my voice, clap twice. If you can hear my voice, clap three times. I know folks are still getting food, and please take your time. There's gonna be a lot of time to eat. There's gonna be time to get seconds. But I wanna take a moment to kind of ground us in what we're doing today. So I invite you to just take a moment to listen. We share this sacred time this morning, both in person and virtually across miles. We gather around tables with warm conversation and nourishing food. We embrace a truth of our world, that our bodies and our spirits are deeply connected. When we sit down to share a meal, we do more than just satisfy our hunger. We are practicing gratitude for the earth's abundance, for the hands that grew the food, picked the food, packaged the food, delivered the food to the hands of this community that transformed that food into a meal. Sharing a meal is an embodied spiritual practice. Each bite, each sip, each word reminds us that spirituality isn't just something we think about or feel, it's something that we live. The poet Wendell Berry wrote an essay titled "The Pleasures of Eating." He writes, "Eating with the fullest pleasure, pleasure that is, that does not depend on ignorance, is perhaps the profoundest enactment of connection in our world. It is in this physical act of giving and receiving, those who brought the gift of food and those who brought the gift of presence, gifts that everyone in this room and on Zoom are able to receive. In the warmth of this community and in the mindful presence of belonging, we bring us to the tables in this room." So we are going to enter a time together this morning focusing on the sacredness of community, inviting us to be fully present in our bodies, through our stomachs, and through our voices and through our ears. May this meal, this time, and this connection together this morning feed our bodies, but also feed our souls. And maybe we will discover new ways to live out the values of generosity, sharing, community in every patient step in the line for food, in every word shared by your neighbor, and in every bite your body welcomes into itself. And so it is in the light of that act of community, the act of a meal, that I'm going to light our chalice this morning. Because we light this chalice in the spirit of generosity, a flame that reminds us of the warmth we share in community, and may its light inspire us to give and receive with one another today. Amen, blessed be, and namaste. And we will take a few more minutes to let folks gather food. And in the meantime, I want to invite, once everybody is seated, I will invite the choir up to open our space with a song. So please take your time to get the food, and then the choir will come forward. mysteries and the truth of our life. And if you're at a table with a bunch of people you know really well, and you're able and you feel called, I would love to invite some folks, or maybe if you're sitting in the back and you don't have a table, I want to invite you to find a table with an open seat and meet someone new. So in the spirit of generosity, community, and sharing, may our conversation begin. If you can hear my voice, clap three times. We're gonna, just in a minute, we're gonna wait for our friends on Zoom to wrap up their conversations. But while we wait for that moment, I just want to invite some reflections from all of you, and you can just yell out kind of in one word, from your conversation at your table, when you think of generosity, what are some words that come to mind?
Caring.
Caring. Joy, empathy. What was that? Sharing.
Service.
I want to invite our friends on Zoom, if we're able to unmute our Zoom people so that our friends on Zoom can share a couple words if they feel so called. When you hear the word generosity, what are some words that come to mind?
The people on Zoom are just still coming back.
Okay, they're still, thank you, Mary.
They'll be back in 17 seconds.
A hoot nanny.
Oh, yeah. Once I go to close out the breakout room, they have a minute before it actually closes.
Yeah. I'm watching, I can see the countdown on the screen. Anticipation.
They should be back. There they are. They're back. So if you want to ask again.
I want to welcome back our friends on Zoom. And Zoom, you are unmuted to the gathering room right now. And I want to invite you to share, when you hear generosity, from your conversations this morning, what are some words that come to mind? So if you're on Zoom and you feel called to share out loud, we can hear you in the great room.
Giving and receiving?
Giving and receiving, thank you.
Caring.
Caring.
Love.
Friends. Love. Friends. Friend. Good times. Friends. Laughing. Taking care of each other.
Easier to give than receive.
Thank you. Thank you to our friends on Zoom. We could, as we move into these next pieces, and I want to lean into what our Zoom friend said of laughter and sharing. There are moments of empathy and caring for one another, and know that not every Sunday here is a banquet, though it seems to feel that way in the past few weeks. But, and thank you, David. David said it was a banquet of love. So as I want to invite our choir back to offer us an anthem. Once again, in our practice of giving and receiving.
Now is the time in our service to share our bounty. We are an entirely self-supported organization, so your gifts contribute directly to sustaining our collective search for spiritual meaning and our work for a just and accepting society. All of your giving options, electronic or otherwise, are on the screen behind me or in your Zoom window. Share the Plate is part of our commitment to support our community. Every month, our Share the Plate recipient receives a portion of your donations, reflecting our mission to reinforce good works throughout Northern Nevada. Appropriate for November's theme of generosity, our Share the Plate partner is the Reno Posse. For the past 9 years, the Reno Posse has fed our unhoused neighbors every Wednesday during the week. They currently feed over 175 people, and if you extend that over 9 years, that's over 90,000 meals made. Volunteers include cooks, bakers, baggers, and servers, all of whom make this possible. You can participate at home by picking up a meal kit complete with recipes most Sundays out in our gathering room. Additionally, donations of snack bars, juice boxes, bottled water, and other single-serving, individually packaged food items are always welcome. Also today, the Reno Posse has flyers out in the gathering room explaining their work in greater detail than I can give you from the pulpit. So I invite you to take an informational handout with you on your way out. And finally, as the month of November is coming to a close, the Reno Posse just wants to say thank you for all the sharing and all the support from this community. And now, may the greeters come forward. It's a little difficult. Maybe the greeters can circulate.
I'd like to take this opportunity to thank our piano guest piano player, Jonathan Baker. Please, he plays so beautifully, and we get him another time. Thank you.
I'd like David to come up here and join me as we bless our offerings. To the work of this fellowship, which is helping more people grow in love, faith, justice, and joy, we dedicate ourselves and these our offerings. Thank you. Thank you for the lovely music.
As our service draws to a close this morning, I will extinguish our chalice, knowing that the light of this community is not extinguished in a single breath, but rather is carried forth in the breath of all of us gathered here today. So I want to invite you in body or spirit to please rise for the benedictions and invite the choir up for our choral benediction. Remain standing, and I invite you, if you have not already, to hold hands with the people around you. And if holding hands is something that you'd rather not, I invite you to place your hands over your heart. We gathered in the spirit of this morning, in the spirit of generosity, in sharing of ourselves and receiving from community. May the wisdom, the stories, the joy, the laughter, the heart experienced today take root in our bodies so that we may leave this place with joy, full of spirit, sustenance, and love. Though our worship has ended, our service is just beginning. Amen. Blessed be, and namaste. I could get some help.